Thank you. we're calling solutions points that satisfy equations, just like that's exactly what graphs are. And if I want to satisfy more than one equation, I have to make sure that that point works in all the equations. So in this case, we'll get no solutions. There's no point that's on both lines at the same time. All right, there is another possibility for parallel lines. What did I assume by drawing parallel lines like this? I assume that basically they weren't the same. So how do you draw that? Very easily. I'll just go back and forth across the line a couple times. In this case, our solution is one-dimensional, so this will show up. So this is a one-dimensional solution, which means one free variable. So free variable is a word. Quickly go back to the single solution. If you just think about a point, how many dimensions does a point have? So think about dimensions as how many directions can you move? So if you're on a line, you really can only go one direction. You can go forward. This is a zero-dimensional solution. Which means you have zero free variables. All right, so these are the three-dimensional space. So now we're going to look at the possibilities in three-dimensional space. And we're going to do our best to draw out different planes. Of course, you can have three lines in two-dimensional space, four lines in two-dimensional space. But the types of solutions you get will always be one of these three types. Maybe I'll talk about more than two lines. So if you have three or more lines, things get a little bit more tricky. You can have no solution looking like that. You could have two parallel the same one, and then a third line cutting through, and that right there would be one solution, which I should not write infinite solutions. So one solution could be some parallel lines, one other line intersecting, and that would be one solution. The only way to get infinite solutions with three lines is have all three being parallel. So if all your lines. three-dimensional space, how in the world do we get one solution? These are think about. Just think of two pieces of paper, like ones in your notebook, are probably parallel, even though they're super close to each other. But here's two parallel planes. Just think of papers stacked up. What does not parallel look like? Just rotate one of them some amount. How do two non-parallel planes intersect? So they'll intersect an entire line. All right, so if you got non-parallel, we got an entire line. So that's what I'm going to draw their intersection. So it looks like there's two, but what we actually get. And this is non-parallel planes. A line is a one-dimensional variable. And when you see one free variable, you know you're looking at a line. One way planes can intersect. So let's go with parallel planes. So do your best to draw two the same above the other one. So we get no solution here. Draw two planes that are exactly the same, so we'll just draw the same plane over itself a couple times. If your plane, then every point on the plane is a solution. So every point is on both planes. So planes are two. So we have two free variables in this case. So two free variables means a two-dimensional solution. if I have a linear system, why could I never have a three-dimensional solution? What does one linear equation limit me to in three dimensions? Next week, and then do a whole lot of linear algebra.